Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. My name is Coaster Chal, and welcome to Coaster Chal, the YouTube channel. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. Coaster Chal here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update, where today Silver Dollar City have begun construction on the site that's set to be for this new indoor roller coaster project rumoured for the park for the next couple of years. And now, before we get started with all the information around the latest construction, please like the video if you loved it, comment down below your thoughts and opinions, subscribe if you are new around here, click notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Also, check the description down below for social media links and the Google Forms link, where you behind the camera can submit your own video ideas. And for now, guys, let's talk about Silver Dollar City and the latest construction on site. So the latest construction is underway and will go vertical once the season is wrapped up, weather permitting. Presently, the focus is on relocating the utilities out of the site, and the current rumour still stands as firing the hole 2.0 in the form of an RMC powered coaster. Now, construction is well underway on the site for the firing the hole 2.0, focusing on relocating utilities, vertical construction starting after the season ends. That was basically what was repeated in the Reddit post. There was stuff from the forum, stuff from the Reddit post that are cross-referencing each other. Now, from the latest construction, you can start to see diggers on site, you can see trucks on site, you can see craneage on site, you can start to see the scoopers scooping up the mud. It's getting the site all ready and prepared, and it's only a matter of time now before we start to see vertical construction once the season ends. Now, before we talk about the project in question, I'm going to share my thoughts on the latest construction. There we are, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, Midwest info guide, construction pictures on Reddit, shared in the forums. Massive shout out to Midwest info guide for those pictures, credit goes to him for all of them, pictures on site. Now, obviously, Silver Dollar City are constructing a huge project here, and the current rumour, as said before, stands as follows: an RMC indoor powered coaster to replace Fire in the Hole in the lineup, not the site, but in the lineup, so that then they can remove Fire in the Hole and replace it with something else, whether that's an outdoor coaster, and probably not an indoor coaster, because that's what the rumored new project's going to be. But it's possibly a indoor dart ride, it could be an outdoor coaster, and they take the whole building of Fire in the Hole down. There's rumours aplenty about what they could do with Fire in the Hole, and I may actually do a separate video on that at some point next year, so stay tuned for that one. But I think it's an interesting one. I think an RMC power coaster would be a very interesting direction to go for Silver Dollar City, and a very interesting direction for RMC as well, because, you know, when RMC was first coming into the scene, they were sort of, you know, replacing the old track on old wooden coasters with, you know, new steel track, the topper track, or they're bringing the iBox track, and they're bringing some steel structure as well, and gradually they get bigger and bigger and bigger, and, you know, convert some of the most classic wooden coasters out there for many different reasons. Rattler at Fiesta Texas, Texas Giant over Texas, the Roar at Discovery Kingdom, Colossus at Magic Mountain. Different wooden coasters. You know, it wasn't just Six Flags though. You had Mean Streak at Cedar Point becoming Steel Vengeance. You had Hurler at King's Dominion becoming Twisted Timbers, you know, and you got the ones from scratch as well. You got coasters like Zadger at Energylandia, and, you know, you had the transformation of White Cyclone at Nagashima Spa Land. So, you know, obviously you've got these different takes of RMC, and now we're entering a different direction for RMC, a possible powered coaster in a building, in a brand new site at Silver Dollar City, and it would be the park's second RMC after the 2013 Outlaw Run. So obviously this is the park's second RMC. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it's the only park, it'll be the only park in the world to have two RMCs in the same park. Well, two RMCs that are not one topper track and one single rail, for example. It's like two of the same track, I mean. Like, it's not like the same two RMCs in the same park, but I mean like two RMCs using the same track in the same park. So, you know, I might be wrong though. Maybe if it's a power coaster indoors, it might be using the single rail track, who knows. But I'm really excited for what this project could be, whether it is that or not. And I'll keep you guys updated. So thank you very much, guys. My name is Coaster Jal. Kill it on the coast of life. I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a silver dollar-tastic day.